How's it going, everybody? It's Pilot Flame, and we are back with another FPL live stream. And today, the deadline stream for game week 19, double game week 19, to be precise. I didn't put that up on the graphic. I should have, though. So hopefully you all had a fantastic holiday season, as well as Happy New Year. It's 2023. We're getting kicked off. A couple of games have already been in 2023, but this is the first game week starting in 2023. And it's a double game week. We have Fulham and Chelsea on the docket. And the title of the stream is no Mitrovic. My team currently does not have Mitrovic, and I'm debating on whether to bring him in. I also potentially have another issue with one of my defenders. We'll get onto that as well. It's one of the first games. So I currently already know one of the team news, and we'll get onto that in a bit. We'll do that. We'll go on to our predictions as well as we normally do, how we did last week. Do our predictions and differential picks for this week as we normally do, and take any questions you have in the chat. JB Cullen says, how are you doing today? I'm doing fantastic. Another FPL deadline means hopefully good things because we had a red arrow last week. So two in a row, I believe, which isn't ideal. So we got to fix that. So without further ado, let's get into it. So as you can see, we got the deadline timer back up at the top there as we do on our deadline stream. So last week, we'll kind of go through this fairly quickly because we want to get onto some of the more recent things. So 51 points with a minus 4 because we brought in both Kukurea and Kepa. We got rid of Iversen and the injured Reece James. The hit did not pay off because Ward ended up getting 3 points, so not ideal. We were 2 points down on, or it would have been 3 points down on that because we would have probably played Ben White. So a bit unfortunate there. But overall, basically, our differential picks didn't do enough. So nothing from De Bruyne, nothing from Foden. Cucurella didn't keep a clean sheet. Neither did Robertson or any returns. Martial didn't do anything. The only player that was kind of like a lower percentage owned player was Darwin Nunez, and he only got himself 3 points. So all in all, not great. We saw ourselves drop down, I think it was around like 200k places, which is not ideal. So we'll have to hopefully fix that. JB Cullen says, Mount or Andreas Pereira captained? If I had to choose, I would probably say Mount, just because it's a bit more of a proven player. But you never know. You never know. I don't dislike the Andreas Pereira shout, so could be something I could do this week too, because I have Pereira, but I don't have Mitrovic. Mount, I would probably say, is probably the more likely. It just seems a bit, it seems a bit more sensible. You know what I mean? Robert not starting today, I don't think. That is correct, actually. Team News and Tix is somebody who I follow over on Twitter. A lot of people follow him over on Twitter as well. And he's basically put his passport is Greek, but we all know he's Scouse, Simi, which is Simikas, which means Kostas Simikas is most likely going to start. Obviously, it's never 100% confirmed. Simikas looks to be starting as well. I'm seeing a lot of FPL managers getting rid of Martial and bringing in Mitrovic and captaining him just because he does have that double game week. I'm seeing a lot of managers bringing in Luke Shaw, who's been fantastic. Will most likely move to left back for United's next game versus Bournemouth because of the fact that Lisandro Martinez would have had a full week and a bit of training and is probably going to slot straight back in, even though Shaw was fantastic at center back as well. So I'm seeing a few teams like that. I'm just going to scan through Twitter just a little bit here, see if I pick up anything else. Some people are considering Darwin Nunez to be gotten rid of to bring in said Mitrovic. What else we got here? Just trying to see if there's anything else. Let's see. Mitrovic is still going to be on penalties. I did see that quote as well. Another thing to note. basically Marco Silva saying that he's going to be there when he's needed. JB Cullen says, I have the same front line and I just can't sell them for Mitrovic. I know. Part of me wants to just sell Martial and just be done with it because... and just deal with them, like, just get Mitrovic over the line type of thing. But then I kind of don't want Mitrovic afterwards. Like, if we look at the fixtures here, like, he has Newcastle away, which is tough. Spurs, he'll probably do well. But then Chelsea again. Maybe I want him for here? I don't know. I definitely want him for this. That looks good. So, I don't know. I don't know. Let's move on to our predictions and whatnot. And we'll go through that. So last week, we had 11 points and 3 out of 5 on the differential picks. Now, the way the point system works, so if we get an exact score, we get 3 points. If we get the result right, we get 1 point. And if we don't get anything, we get 0 points. So let's run through our predictions, shall we? Let's bring up our tweet for Game Week 18. I also want to apologize because I didn't post my team for Game Week 18, which is... It was basically what I said on the preview stream, which was Kukure and Kepa, basically. So yeah, apologies for that. But we'll post our team definitely after this because I'll need to take a screenshot of it and everything. So because it is the deadline stream, and we got to make up our minds. So West Ham Brentford did not go the way of a draw. We got that one wrong, but we did get the Liverpool Leicester score exactly right, so 3 points there. Man United winning 1-0 over Wolves, so Marcus Rashford's second goal was denied because of the handball rule, which is basically if it hits off your arm at any point in time off the goal scorer and goes in the net, then it's a no goal, even though Marcus Rashford's hand was basically in his body. It's kind of a dumb rule, but it is what it is. I knew it was going to get disallowed, but so 1 point for that. Bournemouth Crystal Palace got that one exactly right too, so we got 3 points there. We also got the Fulham Southampton score exactly right in 2-1, so 3 points there. We're doing really well this week. This where potentially it falls apart. Man City and Everton predicted a 3-0 win for Man City. It would end up being 1-1, and save for Newcastle predicted a win there, and they did not win either. It was a draw in both cases, so nothing there for those two. Arsenal versus Brighton. I predicted 2-1 Arsenal. It ended up being double that on both sides. So we got ourselves 1 point there. Spurs losing to Villa 2-0. Did not get that one right. And neither did the Chelsea score, which ended up being 1 apiece. Just my luck bringing in two Chelsea defenders slash goalkeeper. And they concede to to Nottingham Forest, who, when they go down 1-0, or when they go down a goal, they've never scored in the Premier League this season until that game, which is a bit annoying. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of the 10 fixtures correct in terms of the result. And we got 3, 6, 9, 10, 11 points again as well. So we tied our score from last week. Differential picks, clean sheet. Crystal Palace, bang. Guaita also got himself, I believe, a bonus point or a save point. In this, so let's just scroll down here. Guaita, he did get himself a bonus point. Didn't get 3 saves though, which is interesting. So we got that one right as well. Cesar Azpilicueta was not involved in the goal, although he did start and he got booked, so he was not the greatest pick over Cucurella, so unfortunate there. Saïd Benrahma did not get involved in any West Ham goals because they did not score any. But Nketiah did. Nketiah got himself a goal, so that is a 3 out of 5, so we matched what we did last week. 3 out of 5 on the differentials, and 11 points. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. So I'm going to write it down in the notebook, and we review them at the very, very end of the season as part of our FPL kind of review. So 11 points. 3 out of 5 on the differentials. There we go. Lovely jubbly. Hey Zodiac, how's it going? We just went through our predictions. You can see it on the screen here. But overall, pretty good for the predictions. Pretty bad for the FPL team, which is never great. So let's bring up our predictions for this week. There we go. That's what we wanted. Probably going to need some help on the differential picks this week too, because don't really have many, because double gamings are kind of hard because of the fact that like players percentages are usually inflated because they have a double game week. Just before we do that, I'm going to check just to be sure if there's anything else on the old Twitter to see if there's anything if there's anything lineup related. We do know that it seems it's very high chance that Robertson is not going to be starting. It's going to be Tsimikas who's going to be starting. Let's see here. Let's see. All right. Don't see anything too crazy. See a lot of Mitrovic captain is what I do see. But I don't see anything else crazy. So I'm just going to minimize that. Zodiac says, I don't have Mitrovic. Feel like I want to do it because of fear of missing out. Yes, that is a real thing. But I don't think it's the right move for me. Want to keep Martial and then go for Wilson next week if United don't get the double game week at 20. Thoughts? I think that is a good move. I think it's a good move. It's something I'm considering as well. I currently don't have Mitrovic. And there are better players potentially to captain as well. If Mitrovic goes up against Leicester, they have kind of a poor, frustrating performance. He gets booked, then he's useless in the Chelsea game. Right? And he ends up getting 1 point and you're looking, you got egg on your face. Meanwhile, at the end of that week, going into Thursday, or the end-ish of that week, where Chelsea aren't looking great and Haaland is literally scoring every game. it just seems like Haaland just seems to be the kind of player I want to lean to. But I also kind of want to captain Rashford too, who plays Bournemouth, who he has had a history of destroying Bournemouth in previous seasons too. So, how do I do this? I don't know how to do this. 1 second, I'm just trying to fix something here. One thing is broken on my end. Also, Jadon Sancho, for those who are Man United followers or are looking for a potential other Man United asset. How does my team look like? We'll show that off in just a second here. Yeah, we'll show that off in just a second. I'm just going to do the predictions really quickly, and then we'll get on to it. So let's run through them. Right. Got a bit distracted there. So, Brentford-Liverpool. I think Liverpool is going to... should be Brentford. This could be, again, Ivor Toney's last game. He's still got that looming kind of bet scandal thing over his head. Derek_32 says, Cancelo or Trippier? Trippier for me. I would say Trippier, even though he does play Arsenal and it is away from home. I think Trippier for me, personally. I think both teams are going to concede, but I think Cancelo isn't guaranteed to start at the moment. And Zodiac says, I'm not sure if I should start Ward or Ederson. That's an interesting point, actually. I'd probably just start Ederson. Likelihood is Chelsea kind of have a bad game and City just end up beating them. But yeah, City have conceded some really dumb goals recently. Darragon the 32 says, thanks, no problem. Who's your captain at the moment? Kind of Haaland, sort of, at the moment. But we'll get onto it in a sec. Let's just run through these predictions. Arsenal, I think, are going to win 2-1. I think it's going to be close. I think probably a draw is probably the most likely, but I'm going to go with 2-1 just because I favor Arsenal. Probably at home, if this was at Newcastle. If this was at St. James's Park, I would favor Newcastle in this instance. Brighton-Everton, I predict Brighton to win 2-1 over Everton. Leicester-Fulham, I predict a 2-2 draw. Both teams do concede, so I think it's going to be a draw there. Probably the only clean sheet that we've got here is Man United 3-0 over Bournemouth. I think this should be pretty straightforward. Southampton and Forest, I've gone with a 1-1. I think it's just going to be kind of a drab draw. It could be a no-no, to be honest. Leeds and West Ham, I've gone with a 2-1 win for the home team in Leeds. Aston Villa, same thing, 2-1 over Wolves. Crystal Palace and Spurs, a London fixture here. I've gone with a 1-1. Spurs have not looked good recently. Chelsea versus Man City, I've gone with the 2-1 away win for Man City. And then Chelsea to bounce back versus Fulham in the final game week of the double game week on the 12th of January. I've gone with a 2-1 win in favor of Chelsea. For the clean sheet differential picks, clean sheet, I've gone with Manchester United. Goalkeeper, we could take a look here. Who would be a differential goalkeeper this week out of these fixtures? Let's take a look here. Dean Henderson should be high up on the list, right? In terms of like differential pick. I'm going to go with Dean Henderson. He's 9.4%, but he's not going to be somebody who you would think would be like a standout goalkeeper. Yeah, Henderson or Bazunu probably would probably be the one that would probably be the, like the differential. But I'm gonna go with Dean Henderson just because Forrest kind of seemingly just kind of concede goals all the time. ZX says Ward got a bigger ceiling if they keep a clean sheet and tons of saves, but there's a bigger chance of a clean sheet. Yeah, exactly. It's that dilemma: saves versus clean sheet potential. But Wout Face was just putting the ball in his own net for some reason. The first one was unlucky. The second one was definitely avoidable for sure. Because like the three scenarios is the ball goes in the goal, in which case you have no way of stopping it. The ball goes to the side of the post, in which case you have no way of stopping it. Or the ball hits the post. And he should have just assumed that the ball's going to hit the post so that he can clear it better, which he didn't do. Iowa says 50-50 on Haaland and Rashford. I'm pretty much in that boat too. Derek Underscore 32 says Trossard or Almiron this week. Trossard or Almiron. It's got to be Leandro Trossard, surely. Surely. Versus Everton. Much weaker opposition. Both are away from home. Leandro Trossard, I think, for me, would be the, if I had to choose an option to play versus bench. And Zodiac seems to agree as well. Into defenders. Let's go for it. Let's go for Tsimikas. Looks like he's gonna play. And he's 0.3% owned. So why not? If you want to swap out Robertson really quickly, I don't know what the extent of Robertson's injury is, whether it's just for the 1 week or whatnot. But Tsimikas could be a differential pick this week. Into midfield. Andreas Pereira is 25% owned, so that's probably not going to work. I'm actually going to go for somebody who has been starting a lot, and he's only 5.7 million. It's Christian Pulisic. Chelsea double game week. Christian Pulisic will probably start one, be benched for one, maybe. But I think he could potentially get some points here. Double gaming 0.7% owned, 5.7 million. You know, he's a quick little switch off like Almiron or something like that. So, yeah, let's go for Christian Pulisic. And then in the forward slot, a differential forward pick. Probably going to have to pick a single game week player here. And I think the one I'm going to go for... Zodiac says Martial. I mean, true. Yeah, Martial. But I picked him last week or week before last. So I kind of trying to stay away from picking the same player, you know, multiple times in a row. Who are we going to go for here? I mean, is Havertz less than 5%? I mean, he's 6.6. Let's go with Havertz. Double game week. Not really that popular. 6.6%, I think, is low enough to where it's going to be considered like a differential. I mean, it seems fairly obvious, but... yeah, and he seems to be just playing game in, game out for Graham Potter. So, yeah, why not? Adams. Yeah, Che Adams, another one. Che Adams will be another one. So, yeah, that's going to be my clean sheet and differential picks. Let me bring up Twitter here, and I'll post because I almost didn't post them last time, which would have been a... which was bad. I deleted the notepad, so I'm going to do that right now while I'm thinking of it. There we go. And that's now over on Twitter, so I can get rid of the notepad. Let me just double check Twitter again just to see if there's anything else. Kanate also, so apparently Liverpool's backline is Kanate and Virgil van Dijk with Alisson, Trent, and Tsimikas. Apparently that's going to be the backline for Liverpool today versus Brentford. Trying to see if there's anything else here. Is there anything else here? Nope, don't see anything at the moment. So we shall minimize that. What's my YouTube channel if I have one? It's the same as it is on here. Actually, I can show you all the socials. So if you type in, like I'm about to right now, !socials, you can see all the different socials that we have. So we have Twitter, YouTube, Twitch. They're all there in the chat for you. But it's pretty much PilotFlame226 everywhere. Pretty straightforward. I didn't want to complicate it and like to have different names for things and stuff. I was like, let me go with the name where I can be kind of the same throughout. So yeah, that's our predictions and differential picks. This is the team currently as it stands up on the screen. Flat Aardvark, I think is how you pronounce it. Watkins, Kane, or Darwin Nunez? Darwin Nunez. If I had to order, I would say Darwin Nunez. If money was no option, I would say Darwin Nunez, Kane, and then Watkins in that order. So Darwin would be first on my list, personally. Even though Spurs are not looking great, Kane can just get a penalty or something. Whereas Watkins, I think, is kind of a bit potential rotation risk. Potential rotation risk. So yeah, this is the team. Kepa in goal with Cucurella as the double up. We have Trippier and Robertson. Robertson is currently either on the bench or he's not going to play at all. So I'm going to just go put in Ben White. I'm going to move up Bueno, because I guess they're just going to rest Robertson just kind of in general. So I'm just going to make that change right now and save it. We got Trippier as well. We got Rashford, De Bruyne, Andreas Pereira, Martinelli, Martial, Haaland, and Darwin Nunez with Phil Foden, unfortunately, first sub on the bench. I'm half tempted to just captain Rashford versus Bournemouth. So we'll keep that idea in mind at the moment. In terms of double game week players I could potentially bring in, I could do Foden, swap him out for Mason Mount, which would mean I would probably have to bench one of De Bruyne or Martinelli, which just doesn't feel good. I could bring in another double game week defender, so I could bring in another Chelsea defender if I wanted to. I don't think that's going to be a great idea, personally. I think just benching Robertson this week, playing Ben White is probably the safer move. And then the other problem I have is, do I bring in Mitrovic? And now Mitrovic has a double game week, but if he does get booked in the first game versus Leicester, he doesn't have a second game. So, a bit interesting. Watkins with good fixtures, consistent and cheap. Kane, double game week, but not in form. And Darwin, too pricey. Not consistent. Okay fixtures. And Brentford are playing a back five. Yeah, they are, but they're also... Liverpool kind of play like a 4-4-2, sort of. With Salah and Darwin kind of playing as like two men up front. Brentford can still concede goals. I would say that Kane has a double game week, but it's not great, really, right? I think it's just not, like, his double game week is basically terrible. He's playing against the first and second place teams in the league, so it's not ideal. And Spurs are playing terrible. But Watkins is good fixtures and cheap, but he also can just randomly just not play over Danny Ings as well, right? And he's also, like, super inconsistent in terms of, like, his actual returns. Watkins is a very streaky player in that regard, which is why I never kind of liked him, because it's always frustrating. Darwin Nunez is frustrating, but the thing is, the stats show that Darwin Nunez is getting all these chances, whereas, like, Watkins can just get two goals out of literally nothing, and then all of a sudden he'll get, like, chance after chance after chance after chance and doesn't score them, whereas Darwin Nunez, across his whole kind of career, he's been more of, like, a volume player. The short career that he has had. Do you think Mitrovic is risky with the yellow over Martial? I think if you're bringing Mitrovic in for a hit, I think it definitely is risky. If you're just doing the straight up swap, which I can do as well, and probably a lot of managers can, I think it's fine. I kind of just don't want to do it because I think that if United do get a double, then Martial is most likely going to be involved in said double. When United get through these couple of fixtures, if one of these is like mashed in a double here somewhere, then it's fine to probably hold him in here, 22 to 25. I think those fixtures are quite good for him and basically for the rest of the season. Like, once United get past City and Arsenal, they're pretty much home free. They play Liverpool at Anfield, which is kind of a one-off, and then Chelsea and Spurs in like later on, but for the rest of it, it's pretty smooth sailing, to be honest, for the most part. At least, obviously there are some games tricky like Newcastle and stuff like that, but for the most part it should be quite smooth sailing. Let me just check back in on Twitter, see if there's anything else concrete. Let's see. see the little celebration they did for McAllister, Brighton. That's pretty cool. Really, really cool. Chelsea defender or Gabriel long term? See, I think Arsenal defense long term isn't actually all that. I think Arsenal defense in the next three is not great. I think they concede to all three of these teams, to be honest, because North London Derby, anything's possible. United are the only team to beat Arsenal this season. Newcastle will probably score as well. Everton away is probably on the track. But I don't think Gabriel would be the defender I would go for. Yeah, Chelsea now would probably be good. It just makes more sense. Arsenal later. Like, even Chelsea, like yeah, they have Liverpool and yeah, they have Man City, but it's a double game week there. Liverpool, okay, it's whatever. But the rest of their fixtures are pretty good. For at least a long stretch. So it is still worth having, whether it's a defender or a physical goalkeeper. Yeah, the Arsenal defender can definitely wait for a few weeks for sure. And if you got to bring in one, I think Ben White's got to be it, to be honest. I think Ben White has got to be it. He's just cheaper. He's a fullback. Although he doesn't get forward, you know, a crazy amount like some fullbacks do in the league, like a Trent or Robertson or Reece James when he's fit. But I think he just is just looking the part. So yeah, that's how I would go for it. Derek underscore 32, thank you for following. Much appreciated. Much appreciated. Digne, I've been trolled by Digne in the past. I have a kind of a sore relationship with Digne. Basically, every time I got him, he always just got injured every 30 minutes. So it's a bit of like a bad kind of relationship there. He's like, yeah, like Zodiac says, he's one of the biggest trolls in FPL history, to be honest. I mean, if he stays fit, then sure. But I'm not going to go there, to be honest. I'm not going to go there. I just think his past has shown that when he looks like he's getting to that level where you're like, oh, we could consider him as an FPL option now, he then just gets injured or gets a red card or gets an own goal or something stupid. And then it just like, you know, it goes kind of west really quick, right? What else do we have here? Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of Mitrovic captain, but I'm just hoping that he gets booked in the first game and then and doesn't score, so That's what I'm going to have to hope for. So yeah, that's what I think I'm going to have to, what I'm going to have to do. Actually, I'm going to vice captain Andres Pereira just because it's hilarious. In the event Marcus Rashford's alarm clock doesn't work, you know. I mean, Mitrovic just getting booked in the Leicester game. Like, literally, if Mitrovic just gets booked and doesn't play the Chelsea game, then it's fine. But the thing is, right? Leicester away isn't an easy game. And Chelsea at home isn't an easy game. But Mitrovic can definitely score against any team in the league because he just has that brute force and just aerial ability where he could just nod in a header, right? His penalty taking isn't obviously the greatest. We saw this last game week in game week 18, where he had one saved. But I think that United could just rip Bournemouth to shreds, and Martial could be involved in that. So if you're thinking how many returns are we realistically expecting out of Mitrovic in the two games versus Leicester and Chelsea? What's probably best case scenario? For Mitrovic, what, a goal in each game? It's possible that Martial could get that versus just Bournemouth, right? Because Bournemouth aren't good at the moment. They're not playing well, so I don't know. Raptor told me the referee normally do championship matches. He gets 4 to 5 cards per game, and he's got the Leicester Fulham game. Okay, well, that's a little bit of insight. Is Raptor going without Mitrovic then, Zodiac? I'm not sure what his team looks like, but yeah. Captain Sterling, Fulham bad defense, and could see City probably conceding. Yeah, I think Sterling's a good shout. I think Sterling is a good shout. I'm half tempted to just do like a little bit of a kind of a. Oh, he picked Mitro over Martial. Well, that's counterintuitive. So what's the point? So he tells us this nice useful stat where he can where Mitrovic just could be getting booked, and then he picks Mitrovic over Martial anyway. Sad. And he's a United fan too, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, like I could do a little like switcheroo because I don't have any value tied up in De Bruyne. If anything, he's gone down, which isn't ideal. I could go like De Bruyne to like Sterling, Captain Sterling for the double game week, and then reverse it back to De Bruyne the following week. I could do something like that. That'd be cool. That'd be pretty cool. Any promise that I would go into next week with just one free transfer, which isn't ideal. Let's see. What does Sterling have this season? 4 goals, 2 assists. Not great. Not great. But it would be an interesting little move. Swap De Bruyne. But De Bruyne is gonna score versus Chelsea. Surely. I feel Trippier is a trap and I should start White, but it's scary not to pick Trippier. No, you gotta pick Kieran Trippier. Come on. Kieran Trippier is the best fullback he's the best defender in the game currently. You have to play him. There's no way you don't. Trippier is literally the best. Like, you can't, like, is Mitrovic the best captaincy choice in that this week coming? Well, if he gets booked, then no, definitely. If you have hindsight, then no, right? Is Mitrovic the best forward in the game, period? No, he's not. Erling Haaland is, for sure. Is Trippier the best fullback in the game? Yes. Yes, he is. I'm not sure if points dictate that. They do. He has 116 of them. and the next best player is Fabian Scher, who has 79, who's next. You know? It's like, you have to play Trippier. You can't... So, you play Trippier and he gets 1 point. Well, Ben White's going to probably get 1 point too. You know? Disarkar 517. I think I pronounced it right. My forwards are Martial, Haaland, and Darwin. I'm thinking to bench KDB to allow Andreas to start. Is that crazy? My midfielders are Mount, Rashford, Martinelli, KDB, and Andreas. I think you might have to bite the bullet and bench Martinelli. If that was me, if I have the decision to bench one of Martinelli or De Bruyne for Andreas to start, I would say you bench Martinelli. And there's no way you bench Rashford. I was. There's no way. He's Bournemouth at home. No chance. Martinelli's going up against a tough defense. De Bruyne is going up against his old club that he does like particularly well against. Martinelli's been in good form. But Newcastle ain't easy. Yeah, like Zodiac says, consider Martinelli. Flat Arbark says, Chelsea defender or Trippier? Now, that's tough. This week, Chelsea defender because they have two fixtures, and that's literally only it. Oh, Rashford is captain. Sorry, I misread what you said, I was. I thought you were saying you bench Rashford over this midfielder. I was like, no way, no chance. But Rashford is captain. Yeah, sure. I like it. I have it on it. Oh, didn't hear what you said before I typed it. Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, I mistook it. Yeah. Yeah, no, Rashford captain. Yeah, definitely. But there's no way you bench Rashford this week out of those midfielders, for sure. Yeah, Martinelli is on form. But De Bruyne is also playing, like, I just remember De Bruyne always scoring versus Chelsea. Like, I just see him always scoring versus Chelsea, which is why I'm kind of like, do I get rid of him? Do I think Tony will start? Yeah, I think Tony. I think this is the last game before Tony definitely has to address the ban, basically the like the betting ban thing that he has. So, Odegaard a bigger priority than Saka? Well, since Odegaard's cheaper, it's easy to get, but I think Saka's still pretty good. Think Pep and City will be ready after losing points again. Pep knows that if they lose the game, the trophy is probably Arsenal. So he will start a full elite team. Yeah, I mean, he will. He should. I mean, he should play Foden. That's why I'm terrified of benching Foden this week, unfortunately. And he's injured and possibly. Oh, he got. Oh, right. He did get an injury at the end of the game. Let me see if there's anything on Twitter in regards to that. There's anything like anyone posted like the Brentford lineup. Let's see. Is there anything? I would say if Tony's fit, he starts, but I don't think, I'm not sure if he is, so. I did see him go off injured at the end of the game. So, I don't know. But I would say steer clear because the likelihood is he's probably going to have to serve a suspension. The Sarkar says, yeah, KDB does well against Chelsea, and that's why I have a headache. Yeah. I would say KDB, you can't bench a premium, can you? You can't. You just can't. Unless it was like Martinelli at home to Forest. De Bruyne away to Liverpool or something like that, or away to or Chelsea in this case, like a really stiff team. Like Martinelli's playing Newcastle, so it's like it's a bit trickier. Foden, KDB, and Cancelo, the whole elite. I don't think Cancelo's gonna start, to be honest. But that's just me personally. I thought he was terrible for Portugal when he was. Terrible when he plays for City, to be honest. In recent times. That's why I went triple City attack, but unfortunately Pep just doesn't think that Foden's good, apparently. Even though Mahrez and Grealish do the exact same thing every game and just constantly like just yeah, Mahrez got an assist in the last game, but like they just don't provide the same like movement that Foden does. No way Lewis starts over Cancelo. Pep's done weirder things. He has done weirder things. Why is Mahrez playing? I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, Cancelo's very good going forward, but it's defensively that's his problem. Defensively, he's dreadful. Like just recently, he's just basically been just an open door. People just run through. Whereas like, especially the end of last season, he was very good defensively, and then all of a sudden it's just, I don't know. The new kid that plays at fullback for City is nice. Pep always finds his talented kids. Yes, he is. Martinelli or Saka? Probably Martinelli, I would say, still. Just because he's, especially if you've had him since the beginning of the season. I was just benching Martinelli this week, sadly. Yeah, what do you guys think in the chat? Do you think Martinelli or Foden? Who should I bench? Should I just kind of like split them here and just say, you know, and just have Martinelli over Foden? I have a sneaking suspicion that Foden's gonna play, but yeah. Yeah, everyone seems to be saying start Martinelli. Now, what do we think on the what do we think on this little number here? Get rid of De Bruyne for Sterling and then swap him back. What do we think? And Captain Sterling, go for something like that. Foden will probably start. Yeah, I expect Cancelo probably to start too. Aardvark says he brought in Sterling. Yeah, so what do we think? Get rid of De Bruyne for 1 week, bring in Sterling, and then swap him back. And De Bruyne will inevitably punish me, as he always does. I mean, I don't have anything else to do, to be honest. I don't want Mitrovic, to be honest, because the double gaming, yeah, sure, but the fixtures afterwards aren't the greatest for the next few. I was just not a fan of Sterling. Chelsea don't amaze me. True. But if Martial doesn't get a double game week, you would keep him then. Well, we can let's bring that up. We got some time. We got just under 14 minutes. So let me bring up a FPL.team, which basically allows you to see the like the fixtures easier. There we go. Just trying to see if there's anything else quick on here. Nope, nothing on Twitter. Okay. So you should be able to see the team there. So that's the team currently. We got Andreas in for Foden. Ben White's in for Robertson for this week. So the team looks like that. So what we would do is we'd do something like this. So it'd be De Bruyne out for Sterling. Sterling would get the captaincy. Andreas would be the vice captain. Then the following week, we bring Foden back in for Pereira. Robertson should be fine. Comes back in for Ben White. Sterling would then get removed for De Bruyne again. Haaland would be the captain. Vice captaincy, I guess I'll just put on De Bruyne, because why not? It'd be something like that. Martial playing against, like, Rashford against City is good. Martial against City, I think it's probably fine. I don't think Andreas' fixture versus Newcastle away is good enough. I think Bueno at home to West Ham is potentially okay. But Martial and Rashford have shown against City that they can do things that are quite good versus teams that have a lot of the ball and they can counter. So, and Martial loves playing against City, says I was. So, seems good to me. D. Sarkar says Man United highly will get a double game week. Yeah, it's possible. Do you think I'll miss a lot of points going for Watkins over Darwin using budget for KDB? I just don't like Watkins as a pick. Again, he's like a Digne. They happen to play on the same team. But yeah, I just don't like both of those. I like Darwin just because he's kind of exciting to watch. And I know that Liverpool will score goals and eventually he will start firing. Whereas Watkins has shown over a few years in the Premier League where he just isn't that level. I'm looking forward to selling Mount next week. Yeah, I mean, yeah, a lot of managers of some. I could go Mount too. That's another thing. I could go Mount and Captain Mount. But I think Sterling's probably a bit more fun, to be honest. I like Sterling as a player. I got Sterling's couple of his highs when he was at City. So yeah, be something like this. If Man United get a double game week, obviously that's great. But I don't think a double game week player for Man United is probably worth it defensively to bring in if it's paired up with City, as an example, or if it's paired up the following week with Arsenal. So then I don't need a transfer for that, to be honest. Then I have a bit of predicament because I have Ben White, Cucurella, and Robertson all with bad fixtures. Ward would come in for us. And maybe this is where I look to potentially get something that helps out, because Liverpool's fixtures aren't great. So maybe Robertson would be the one to go in this instance. A lot of the teams kind of just play each other, so maybe I have to work something out there. Or just bank a transfer and just kind of roll with it. And then in 22, we got Kepa coming back in, and the team's looking decent. Obviously that whole time in the single game makes you Captain Haaland. If it's double game, you Captain Haaland. So that sort of stuff seems like it could be a bit of fun. So I might like it. I might go for it. If you feel fine about game week 20, then Sterling could be fun. Are you not afraid of getting stuck with Martial? It's possible. It's possible, but we still have... Like, Martial's cheap enough to where it's like... You can kind of just put him to the side. It's kind of the reason why I kind of regret a little bit of not going with, like, Almiron. He's so cheap that you kind of can just get rid of him or put him on the bench. But, like, Bueno's been playing. So, like, even if I didn't want to play Martial in versus Man City, Bueno has West Ham at home. West Ham haven't been scoring very many goals, so maybe that's an option, like an option there. Martial away to Arsenal is much trickier because all the big teams play each other. So I kind of just want to play him. I'd rather not play Ben White over him, to be honest. So that's kind of just neither here nor there. If he doesn't play, he doesn't play. Then I play Pereira. That's what he's there for. So. It's not the end of the world, to be honest. Do I have two free transfers this week? No, I only have one. You can see it. I have it up on the graphic. That way. Up in the top corner there. So, last transfers this week, 0 out of 1. So, we've made 0 transfers. And we have 1 available. Last week, we had 1 transfer available. And we made 2. Because we took a -4. Yeah, many cheap players this season. Not a big deal to bench when we have good players on the bench. Yeah, exactly. So, like... In the week where, like, say, you know, maybe we don't want Martial versus Arsenal, we still have... And Pereira versus a Spurs team that's not playing well. Bueno, I mean, it's not great. Ben White, it's not great. But they're still there, right? There's still options. We could also just kind of get rid of Martial if we wanted to. In the week versus Arsenal. Like, and we could get... let's see, who's a good striker to potentially bring in for a week? Or 2 weeks. Or whatever. Don't have enough to stretch to Wilson, which would be an option. Maybe we can go back to Solanke, to be honest, if we wanted to. It's possible. Is Gakpo concerned for Nunez's minutes in future games? Potentially. I would say with the current situation at Liverpool where Firmino's still injured, I think, or potentially just coming back from an injury. Jota's out till like February. Diaz is out till February. I think Nunez should be fine. Gakpo, he is an attacker. He plays kind of off the left. They'll just drop Chamberlain. Yeah, so they'll play. The thing is, what it'll do actually for the most part is it will, unless Klopp changes or keeps the current system, Gakpo will get kind of shunted out to the left in like a 4-4-2 type of system. And then you'll still have Darwin and Salah as the two forwards. If they revert back to a 4-3-3, then it becomes all about Nunez through the middle, which actually makes Salah worse. So, we'll see. Yeah. The thing is, I think in most games, if Darwin's starting and Salah's on the pitch and Gakpo's on the pitch, let's say those three, and, you know, Jota and Diaz are still out, I think there's more likelihood that Firmino comes on to add to the team, to put him as like a 10. I think you'll very rarely see Darwin probably get subbed off directly for Firmino, so be interesting to say. He played right wing at PSV or number 10. Yeah, he could also play off the left as well, like he did for Haaland, playing a front two. He's very versatile. Liverpool might start to play 4-2-3-1. They might, yeah, and then might put Firmino in like the 10. Yeah, Gakpo is flexible enough where he can give Salah rest too as well. Mono says, any chance you could look at my team for changes or should I take a -4 with Mount on it? It's on Twitter. Okay, let me check. Hold on. Let's see. I don't see your team, Mono. I could be wrong, but I don't see it. I don't see your team, Mono, so I don't know what it is, but if it is the Mount for -4, if you're going to captain him, then sure, but if you're not, then no. Only -4 for captains, I would say. That's how I see it. I have Trippier ahead of White. Yeah, that makes more sense, to be honest. Got less than 3 minutes. Make sure teams are locked in. Make sure your teams are locked in. Yeah, I don't think we need to take hits for a weak double gaming either. I've done a change. We've done it. We're going to go for something exciting. Let's go for something exciting. And also the one advantage of a... Or sort of an advantage of this. Is both Chelsea's fixtures at the very end. So... Which is kind of cool, I guess. Sort of. We know our pain. What's already happened beforehand. So, gives us hope. Yeah, I know. You know what? You know what I'll do? I'll give him the vice captaincy just to be... To make it fun. How about that? I'll do that. Yeah, make sure to have your teams locked in. Yeah, I'm sad about the Rashford not having a captain. But if he gets double game week, then we go for him next week, right? I think it's something interesting. Sterling flu incoming? Don't say that. That'd be terrible. I mean, it is a long game week away, but that would not be good. TBH. But yeah, less than a minute. And the thing is, with double game week player, if they miss the first game, Sterling's not going to miss the game versus Man City. There's no way. He'll probably do everything he can to play versus his former club. So, and if there's a player that knows probably Man City inside out and backwards, it is Sterling. So, it's fine. It's fine. We're going for it. Something fun. Yeah, less than 30 seconds. Make sure to have your teams locked in. I'm going to refresh. I should probably take a screenshot of my team as well while I'm thinking of it. So let me do that on my phone really quickly. If I can get the FPL website up for it. Oh, it went away. So I got to do it on my computer. One moment, please. Yeah, I have to do it. Let's try this one again. There we go. I got it. So I'll tweet in a bit. But yeah, that's the FPL deadline. As you can see up above, deadline is over. If I refresh this, this will probably break. It will. So yeah, let's move over to the big screen. Now, we didn't get a chance to look at Fantasy Football Scout stuff, but I think Fantasy Football Scout deserves a shout-out as well. So make sure to shout out and check out Fantasy Football Scout. They're fantastic. We didn't look at any of the tables today. I think the captaincy table's kind of been, the Christmas period's a bit weird, and we'll get back to it when fixtures kind of normal again. But check them out, link description and in the about sections on our platforms. They can help improve your FPL game. They've certainly improved mine. At least for last season. This season, not so much, but hopefully it can. Just getting more information is always kind of good. That's going to do it for the Game Week 19 deadline stream. Make sure to like, favorite, comment, subscribe. Thank you for joining me on the stream as well. May the arrows be green, as Zodiac says. And we will be back. When will we be back? We'll probably be back on... we might do something. I think we'll probably do something on the Thursday evening after the Chelsea game, the first Chelsea game when they play City. We'll probably do something there. That'll probably be more of like a preview stream sort of thing. And then if there's anything throughout the week that happens, whether it be double game week announcements, something like that, we'll make sure to check that out. And then we'll be back probably the Thursday evening after the second Chelsea game to go over as like a deadline-ish sort of stream for the game week for game week 20. So make sure to do that as well. But the videos will start to come back, or at least they should. I've got to get back in the swing of things. You know, taking the Christmas break, was a little bit on vacation. Things are a bit scattered, but yeah. Thank you all for watching. Like, favorite, comment, subscribe, follow us on all the socials. Until the next one, take care.